So, you're new to CANoe and want to create your first configuration? Let me guide you through and we'll also see the main elements of CANoe's user interface. Hello, I'm Christian from Vector Support. In this tutorial series, we will show you how we can create a simulation of two control units with CANoe from scratch. Step by step, we'll set up the control of a hospital bed with a remote. But you can easily adapt these steps to your use case. In this video, we'll create a configuration and make ourselves familiar with the basic elements of CANoe's interface. Let us start by opening the CANoe application. We want to create a new configuration from scratch. We will be using one of the CAN templates, more specifically the CAN 500 kilobaud one-channel template, which is based on a single CAN network. Then we enter a name for our configuration and select where we save it. The location is our project directory where related files are stored. This ensures that the files used in the configuration will be available on relative paths to a CFG file, and we can share the project with colleagues by copying the project directory. Now you can see that CANoe has three important windows opened: simulation setup, measurement setup, and write window. More on them later. First, in the Home tab, we have the possibility to use a real bus or simulated bus. If we wanted to use real hardware, we'd keep the real bus option. But as the CAN frames never leave CANoe, we switch to simulated bus with a factor of 1. Now, we will have a look at two main windows of CANoe. Let me quickly explain their purpose. We'll fill them with content in a later video. The simulation setup contains those CAN nodes which are part of the remaining bus simulation. For example, simulation nodes resembling simulated control units. The simulation setup is a graphical representation of our network. So far, our network has no nodes and no database yet. To the right, you can find the measurement setup. This window collects communication from the bus. For the most part, this will be bus events and system variables. These are sent to various connected analysis windows, like trace or graphics window. Let's look at some of the powerful analysis windows which CANoe has to offer. They allow us to analyze the past and current communication on the bus. The trace window shows the communication on the bus, in our case, the CAN frames. In other configurations, further events like Ethernet packets or function calls show up. If there is a corresponding database available, it will automatically decode the raw data, allowing you to expand the frames, showing the contained signals with their names and signal interpretation. In our next video, we will see this with actual data. The graphics window visualizes the signal values over time. On the left, there's a legend to which we can drag the signals. On the right, the graphs are displayed. The view is also customizable. We have another window that is available by default. It is the write window. It displays important system messages during the CANoe measurement. For example, debug info, and it indicates when a logging function has been triggered. It can also display information about errors that occur. Of course, the window is currently empty as we haven't started measurement yet. To sum it up, we have seen the most important elements and we created a configuration. Let's bring it to life and see some CAN communication in the next video. If you want to follow along this tutorial series, subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel for more videos and check out the playlist in the description. On to the next episode of our series. We will add and edit the database and then see all these windows in action.